First things first, I read the comments on yesterday's Spider-Man video, and I'm not gonna lie, it put a smile on my face. So many people said I didn't even know you were a fan of the MCU or pop culture or comics. More of this, Chaos COD video, Spider-Man video, it works. Thank you for all the support. This is a true passion of mine. We'll see where it goes, one day at a time, but thank you for all the love, everybody. Jimmy, your Chaos here, and today, we are going to talk about Kang the Conqueror and the fact that Kang the Conqueror was not in Loki. So here is your official spoiler alert. If you have not seen the season finale of the Loki Disney Plus series, you should probably click off this video right now. But if you have, then join me on this timeline because we're going to talk about Kang the Conqueror. We're going to talk about how he fits into the MCU or should we call it the MCM? I wonder if they're going to officially change it. It can't be the Marvel Cinematic Universe now that the multiverse is there. So Marvel Cinematic Multiverse? Marvel Cinematic Timeline? I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section, and let's get into this. And a lot of people think that Kang is going to be the big, big long-term baddie for the MCU, and I am here to say no, and I'll explain what I mean. We already know that Jonathan Majors is confirmed to be the big villain in Ant-Man Quantumania, but I'll explain why I don't think he is the Thanos-style villain that everything was set up for in the first 10 years of the Infinity Saga. I'll explain what I mean when we get to it. So, first of all, let's kind of set the stage here. Loki. Season 6, I'm not doing a breakdown of that. I kind of missed that when I started uploading here, but you can check out multiversedirect.com if you guys want all that information. That's our new website. So I'm going to give you a quick rundown. Final episode, Sylvie Loki, they go to the end of time or the void, and they find who is behind the TVA. And yes, it is Jonathan Majors, but this is not Kang the Conqueror. This is He Who Remains, or we could say Immortus, or Marvel's way of putting those two together. Let's just, let's deem him a lesser evil version of what could come in the future. Let's put it that way. But I know a lot of people say, oh, Jonathan Majors is Kang the Conqueror. Woo, that's great. Thanks, Loki. This is not Kang the Conqueror. So let's establish that out of the gate and understand who we're actually dealing with here, because there are a lot of versions of Kang or Nathaniel Richards. There's a lot. Immortus, Iron Lad, Rama Tud, Victor Timely, Scarlet Centurion. There are a lot. Kang the Conqueror. So this is Marvel's rendition of He Who Remains mixed with Immortus, which is, yes, it is Kang or Nathaniel Richards, whatever you want to call him, and he's a scientist in the 30th or 31st century, something like that. Basically, he figures out that there's a multiverse, and he figures out that timelines or universes are stacked on top of each other, and he unravels all that. Then all of his variants get into this huge multiversal war to kind of claim dominance on their universe being the best and only universe. Let's just leave it like that. And he does what he needs to do to stop that. He finds Elias, which you guys know is the big guard dog cloud poofy purple thing that eats time and people and variants and all that stuff. And he weaponizes this to kind of balance things. He creates the TVA, has the sacred timeline, everything's okay. He's not a good guy per se, but he is doing what he thinks is best to keep things balanced and keep all the other Kang variants at bay, right? So he tells Sylvie and Loki straight up, you have two choices. One, you two take over because he's old and he's tired and he's just kind of over it. Or you kill me and you stop the only thing that has been a barrier to all the nasty Kang variants that could start another multiversal war. Okay, there we are. Well, you guys, if you've already watched it, you know what happens. Sylvie kills him. Absolutely shatters the timeline. The multiverse is going everywhere. There's branches everywhere, which of course sets up into Spider-Man No Way Home. It kind of validates Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield and everything else we know about that. It also sets up Doctor Strange's Multiverse of Madness, and it opens the door wide open for the MCU to literally do whatever they want. And it is the very, very beginnings of the Secret Wars. So Let's talk about Kang. Everybody wants to know, is he the big, big baddie for the next 5 to 10 years of Marvel? No, I do not think he is at all. I think he is going to be the focused villain of Ant-Man Quantumania, which they've already confirmed, but I don't think he's that next level threat. I still feel that it's going to be this staggered stage thing. Doctor Doom is going to come in somewhere, and I ultimately feel like Galactus will be that Infinity War Thanos-style threat in the end. I do not think it's Kang the Conqueror, although they could spin it around. This guy, I mean, he can basically do whatever he wants. I mean, his abilities include time travel, of course. He's a genius. He's actually a tactician with hand-to-hand combat. He can access any type of advanced knowledge. He can do basically whatever he wants, okay? So keep that in mind as we move forward. Now, like I said in the beginning, this was not Kang the Conqueror. This was Immortus, or He Who Remains. We will see Kang the Conqueror. We actually saw Kang the Conqueror at the very end of Loki. When Loki goes back to the TVA and Mobius and B-15 don't know who he is anymore, it pans away to the statue of Jonathan Majors, Kang the Conqueror, and he has already taken over the TVA. That, to me, is Kang the Conqueror. That is who we are going to see when Ant-Man finally arrives. And then we'll see how they're going to deal with that. Who knows? It's going to be interesting because we know Spider-Man's going to open everything up. We're going to get multiple timelines coming in. But I think it's going to go even farther than that, because by the time we get to Secret Wars, if that is happening, which I truly, truly feel it is, you're talking alternate timelines with multiple sets of Avengers and villains. It's going to get crazy. I'm telling you right now, if you love the buildup of the Infinity Saga, I think we're about to go up by 9,000, which I know is Marvel, most Marvel fans, myself included. It's going to be an exciting ride. So as for Kang the Conqueror, this guy has been throughout the comics everywhere. He is deeply enrooted in a lot of different storylines, in a lot of different captions. We haven't seen him yet, but I am super excited to see Jonathan Majors switch or flip the switch, if you will, because he knocked it out of the park. He came in the very last episode with he killed it. I mean, his range was phenomenal. Just watching him was great. It's going to be cool to see. He played a good version of Kang, and it's going to be exciting to see the actual nasty, super evil Kang the Conqueror version as we go down the time. But I will say once again, this is not the big baddie. If you ask me my opinion, he is just another level. Marvel likes to stack things and layer it, and then you think, oh, this is the top, and then it's not the top. There's something above it and above it, and I definitely feel that's what's going to happen here. Is he going to be a formidable foe? Absolutely. Is Ant-Man going to be able to take this guy out by himself? Absolutely not. And could he be the key to the Secret Wars down the road? Yes, he could. It's going to be interesting because all these timelines opening not only mean other heroes coming in, but they mean other villains from other timelines as well. And that is where things are going to start getting pretty dicey, if you ask me. So there you go, guys. Kang the Conqueror was not technically in Loki, the season finale. Well, there was a statue that we can assume was him, but the Jonathan Majors that you saw was not Kang the Conqueror. It was actually Immortus, and He Who Remains kind of put together. That's how Marvel did it. You guys, let me know what you think. Are you excited? What do you think's going to happen moving forward in the upcoming movies? We've got Shang-Chi, we've got the Eternals, we've got Spider-Man. And once again, thank you for all the love on yesterday's video. One day at a time, but I enjoy talking about all of this. Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon.